Welcome to the Rome School of Music, Drama, and Art, Latin American Music Center's presentation of piano music from Spain and South America. Today we feature Martin Gallegos Noya, a talented pianist and composer from Peru who is pursuing a doctorate in vocal accompanying at the Catholic University of America. We are also commemorating the 100th anniversary of Astor Piazzolla's birth, and will be presenting Invierno Porteño from his Four Seasons and the beautiful and haunting Adios Nonino, written at the time of his father's death. You are definitely in for a treat as we hear piano pieces from Peruvian composers and the beautiful and exotic Danza Oriental by Enrique Granados. Welcome, Martin. It's wonderful to have you here. I've heard the pieces and they're beautiful, and I'm looking forward to hearing you perform in this beautiful Heritage Hall.
Thank you. Thank you very much for this welcoming, and thank you for this interview. Thank you, Gustavo Wally, for organizing this concert, and I look forward to it too.
So my first question is, why did you decide to enter the music profession and go to Catholic to pursue a DMA?
Well, that's kind of like a long answer. Prior to studying music, I obtained a bachelor's degree in computer science engineering, but I always knew that I was a musician inside in my heart and my mind, and eventually I decided to completely change careers. I applied to get the Bachelor of Music in Lima, Peru. And then I had the opportunity to come to the United States to study a Master of Music degree at George Mason University. And then here at Catholic University in this program, Vocal Accompanying, which is actually the only one in the area, which I think it was honestly the perfect program for me. I had discovered during my bachelor's the love that I have for opera. Just this wonderful genre, and I think it was the perfect program for me.
How did you select the repertoire for today's program? And how did you decide to write Impromptu Distante, and what made you choose that title?
Well, each one of these pieces speaks to me in a very special way. I just love all this repertoire. And as far as the Impromptu, while I was studying my Bachelor of Music, I also would play in a restaurant during the nights. So it was pretty much every day. So I had a lot of leeway to improvise. And it was during this improvisation that I voluntarily tried to look for a theme, something that would stick to me. And then eventually I had a piece. And then once I realized how this piece sounded, it gave me some evocations about different memories of my life. So it kind of made me think of long distant memories, right? And since it had been improvised, or it was born from improvisation, that's why I decided to call it Impromptu Distante, because of distance.
So you have a piece named Juan y Cecilia, and what made you choose the title for that piece?
Juan y Cecilia, I actually composed it a little bit after composing the Impromptu Distante, and I decided to name them after my parents, because what better homage to my parents, which who I miss so much now here in the US. They still live in Lima, Peru. It's an homage to my parents. That's the basic idea.
Since it is the centenary of Piazzolla's birth, what are your perceptions about this Argentine composer?
Well, first of all, Argentina is a country that has always been very close to me, very special to me. My dad lived in Argentina for 10 years. My aunt is Argentine. So I've always had this special relationship with Argentina. And of course, with Argentinian culture, and of course, tango, right? I've been listening to tango since I was a little kid because of my dad's old records. And once I discovered Piazzolla's music, it was like a revelation, right? It sounded like tango, but at the same time, it had this kind of jazz or jazzy elements. It's just a combination of so many elements, but keeping this passion of tango. Wonderful music, it's just excellent.
I do like your perspectives on Piazzolla's music. And now for the last question. As a Latin American student at the Benjamin T. Rome School of Music, what have been your experiences in accessing the unique collection at the Latin American Music Center?
Well, first of all, in general, my experience at Catholic University has been wonderful, especially because of the opportunity that I've had to make music with other students, accompany their lessons at the Sacred Music Consort, chamber music. And in the case of the Latin American Center, I think we are so fortunate to have access to this myriad, this plethora of countless compositions that, truth be told, they are not so very well known. So for us, and especially as a Latin American musician, it's wonderful to have this ocean of music waiting for us to be discovered, waiting to be discovered by us, right? And as a matter of fact, this coming recital that I am preparing for my degree is all Ibero-American music, and actually that I discovered through you in your in your class. So yeah, it's a wonderful opportunity that we've had.
Thank you. I agree with you because I am Latin American myself, and for me to be able to give this music to others is just a wonderful, wonderful experience. Thank you.
Of course. Thank you.
Martí, I'm so happy to hear your music today. I think it's going to be a wonderful concert, and I'm sure everyone who hears it will enjoy it as much as I will.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.